Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about pop-up modals, okay, or overlay boxes. Remember in the last video when you clicked the start trial button you ended up at a new page. We're going to do something when you click this button, you ready for it? Just kind of like pops up over the top, fades out the background, and we don't have to jump pages. It feels a little bit more fluid, if that's the word. It's definitely popular at the moment, so we're going to close it down, open it up, close it down. So we're going to learn how to do that now in our prototype in Adobe XD. All right, first thing to do to create a modal is we still need this artboard, but we don't need a lot of the stuff in it. And plus we're still in prototype mode from when we were working the last video. So switch to design and we are going to say goodbye to the nav. I'm going to click on that. Goodbye to the, all the footer. So I've just got this last chunk left. Okay, and where should it be? Oh, there's stuff up there too. Make sure you get rid of everything you don't need. So what we want to do is I just want this chunk. I'm gonna have to make sure you got a white box in the background or something to overlay over the top of the homepage like you saw in the intro. And let's just give it a try as is. There's a few other things I want to do to it, but let's just cut to the chase then. So we're gonna go back to prototype mode and we're gonna say when that button is clicked, what's gonna happen? Instead of going over here and going to this tap transition, we're going to go to tap still, but we're going to say overlay, and that's the magic source. What's going to happen is it's going to overlay that page over the top of this one, excluding the background. Okay, so just the physical things on this page. Let's just give it a preview to see what it looks like. Okay, give it a preview. Cool, huh? And you'll notice by default, if I click anywhere, it gets rid of it. So that's something that just happens by default. A couple of things happen there. One is I did a shortcut to open this preview. Okay, so it is Command Enter on a Mac or Control Enter on a PC. So look down your keyboard, the Enter key, sometimes it's the return, sometimes it's got just a little arrow on it. Okay, so hold those down, that launches the preview, which is cool. And let's have a little look at this thing. So you'll notice it's a dotted line. So the solid line shows a transition, this one here is an overlay. Okay, and the other thing that's happening in here is that it's going to that page, it's dissolving, which is fine, it's got everything else that's perfect. What ends up happening to this page, if I click on it, you'll notice this little icon. This little icon here says when anything else is clicked, just go back to not the page next to it, but whatever page you got it from. So what is it called? Return to previous artboard. So if I click the start trial button on like one of the 100 other pages, it's gonna load this page. And when I click off, it's gonna go back to that original page. Do you get what I mean? So it's not going back to homepage, it's going back to wherever you came from, which is really cool. Sometimes that can be turned off though. Like I've broken it where it's just disappeared like that. And you're like, how do I make that happen again? So you click on it and you say tap, which is perfect. And you go to this one that says action, previous artboard. And then it turns into that little return button and goes to that. A couple other things I want is I want the little cross because clicking anywhere is a bit weird for people. So I'm gonna go back to that wires UI kit, okay, for the wireframes. I've closed mine down. Where are you wires? Okay, and I'm looking for the cross. I could go to Adobe Market or Materials, but I know it's gonna be in here. It's gonna be easy enough to find. Cool, there's a cross. I'm going to break it apart here. So I'm gonna right click it, ungroup symbol. Grab that cross, jump back into my other document, and I'm gonna put it in the corner here. And because I've used that blue, like that we had in that first one, it's just made it easy. I don't have to recolor everything every time. I'll show you a trick for recoloring it all at the end if you are like, man, I hate that blue. So hold shift down, make it a little bit bigger, and that's gonna be my little cross. Even though you can click anywhere, I still feel like you need a button to actually click. So preview, what's the shortcut? Command Enter. Or Control Enter on a PC. Click on there, cool, huh? Close it down, nice. One of the things I like to do, so I'm gonna close it down is, zoom out, is I'm gonna grab a big rectangle, because you saw at the beginning, it kind of grayed out the background. Okay, there's an easy way to do that. Just grab a big old rectangle, give it no border, give it a fill of our black, and then just lower down the opacity of this thing. And then, go back to your arrow tool, black arrow, right click it, send it back. All right, so we're gonna give it a preview and there's gonna be a couple little issues we need to fix. So previewing, and the weird thing is it previewed from this page. You might have already run into this where sometimes it previews from the homepage and sometimes from this. So what ends up happening is if I have nothing selected, so my black arrow, just click in the background, it's gonna default to this homepage. Why? Because if I go to prototype And if I zoom in the top corner here, can you see this little home icon? That just indicates that if XD is not sure which page you mean, okay, it's gonna start from this little home icon. You can change that. You could say start trial could be my home. So that's the default, but that's a bit weird. So I'm gonna go back here. The way to override that and what we did there by accident is if you click the artboard name, start trial, you're kind of telling XD, just preview this one for me, even though I haven't set it as the home. Okay, and if I click it, it's gonna start from there. If I have nothing selected, it'll start from that home screen. Okay, so what's wrong? Let's give it a click, kind of half works. It's kind of in the middle there, and you'd be like, oh, what happened to the top bits and the middle bits? Okay, it's a little bit weird. So let me show you the two things that are wrong. One is it's this first option here. If I go back to design, remember when we're doing my crazy cell phone footage, we changed the viewport height. We should probably just switch it back to matching the both of them, because that's the line that I need, right, when I'm previewing. So I'm gonna copy it and go back to this. It's up to you, they just have to match. Doesn't really matter if you've gone for the shorter or the taller of the viewport heights. Okay, I'm just gonna go back to that original one where we're dealing with the 366 wide and 768, just so I'm aware that that's the, that's the line that I can't design underneath, or at least a lot of people won't see what I put under here unless they scroll. So it's gonna get rid of part of it. Let's preview that. Back to my kind of like skinnier model, but that's okay. If I click on this, it kind of works, but there's still that top chunk. See this bit here? And I'll show you why that is. So if you go to prototype and I click on this and I click on my button, you can kind of see it here. See this big green thing? Okay, it's gonna grab that and jam it and start it wherever the top of this green box is. So what I wanna do is close it down. Can you close it down? I'm just clicking on the blue box and grab that and just move it to the top. Okay, so instead of being kind of part the way down, I've just dragged the center bit to the top. Now if I preview and I click on this, kind of covers the whole thing. There we go. Cool, huh? I love pop-up modals. You might not like them. It's definitely a phase that the internet is in and I'm in. Okay, it's just a way of, instead of jumping through like 20 pages, it allows you to kind of jump, you know, you still be able to see where you are, you can go back to it, and you don't have to have this like completely separate page to jump back and forth. Just it feels like a less extra step, even though really it's not, it's just a trick. Especially for login screens, just something that's quite small. Definitely great for like help boxes. That's, if you click on the little question mark to give yourself a little hint, it can be helpful. And the trick we did today is we put under design, we put a big black box and we just lowered the opacity down and kind of covered it up to make it really stand out against the background. All right, friends, that is it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up, really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.